I tried.
Sorry, honey, sorry. I just gotta crap like a bastard. I can't wait. This is getting... Oh, boy, that is... Here it comes, the second! Oh, God!
Harold couldn't sleep, so he took his purple crayon and drew a world of his own imagination.
Harold, what did I tell you about drawing on the goddamn walls? You know what else is purple? Process! Draw me some whiskey! Oh, God, that is just what I need.
Harold had dreamed of this moment a thousand times. Harold then drew himself a new father. This dad never yelled and had a 3-year chip from AA. He was also good at lifting things. Harold and his new father sailed away to a bright new tomorrow. Harold's mother filed a missing person report, but she never saw her son again. She hanged herself a year later. The rope was purple.
Don't cry, my dear. It's said the human head remains alive for a brief moment after a decapitation. Once my head falls into the basket, allow your beauty to be the last thing I see, and I will bestow one final wink upon you. I don't think he's gonna wink.
And now a story of a nice blonde woman who was raising 3 girls by herself. All of them were blonde as well, just like she was. They were blonde and alone. Now here's the story of her first husband and why he isn't in the picture. He died in a freak workplace accident. That's why he's not around.
Oh, we don't need to talk about the girl's father.
Their father was a scientist working with experimental radiation. The core overheated and his face exploded. Not his whole head, just his face.
Oh my God!
He did not die instantly. He survived the explosion of his face. Imagine a human body with just a weirdo where his face was flailing around in shock.
We were just starting to move on.
Mommy, you said Teddy died in his sleep dreaming of us.
No one wants to hear this part of our backstory.
He tripped and fell out of a plate glass window onto a rusty fence post down below. He impaled his anus on that fence post, but he was still alive.
Bobby, don't laugh at that.
He could still scream even though he didn't have a face. The sound was absolutely chilling. His corpse was never, never, never found. Some say his screams fill the night.
Now do my ex-wife song.
Want a cereal that tastes great and helps relieve pent-up rage?
Yeah!
Time to give breakfast what it deserves. Zodiacs! The nutritious whole-grain cereal with the excitement of a late 60s killing spree! Toasted oats in the same fun shapes as my cryptograms. And the back of every box has a cipher puzzle!
Delicious and entertaining. Who are you?
Nobody knows! Which is why we've mixed in multicolored marshmallows that look like the suspects people thought I might be. The police detective, the librarian, the Navy veteran, even got the guy with a deathbed confession. He's delicious! And also not guilty.
Murderlicious! I hope they never find you.
It's been 50 years! I'd say you've got nothing to worry about other than the safety of your parents! Zodiacs! Unsolvably delicious!
According to Passover tradition, I will pardon one prisoner of your choosing. Will you pardon the murderer Barabbas, or will you pardon Jesus?
Barabbas! Barabbas! Barabbas!
Barabbas, you are pardoned.
What?
Wait, which one is the magic one?
I'm the magic one!
No take-backs, chicken heads!
If you don't buy us, we get killed!
Check it out! I'm a mom! Look at my pretty jacket, because I'm a lady! I've got boobs! Oh my! What the?
Ow!
Is this your mom?
Ow! Ow!
Is this your mom?
Yeah! Yeah! My mommy! Why?
Bring in the horses!
Oh, no, no! No! No!
That'll show you for making fun of my backpack. Oh, wait a minute.
This isn't Billy's place.
Are your hired mercenaries not as good as advertised? Well, come on down to Dave's Mercenary Warehouse. We kill the right guy or your money back.
Hey, kids! Feeling run down from all the chemo, spinal taps, and general malpractice-worthy doctoring? Sounds like you need some critical love, stat! Say hello to the Intensive Care Bears! Try Skin Graft Bear! He's an inspirational patchwork of love!
He smells like morphine sulfate!
Feeling run down? Give a wheeze for Severe Combined Immune Deficiency Syndrome Bear, or SIDS for short!
We both want to walk on grass!
And let's not forget Low T-Cell Bear.
Being born with AIDS won't slow him down.
The Intensive Care Bears. They're a cure for your heart.
Intensive Care Bears only cure your heart metaphorically. Some bears may cause rash, infection, loss of vision, and or loose stools.
Oh, look at the baby.
Konnichiwa, and welcome to Ninja Stars. Tonight we'll see real live ninjas compete to find out who can be the most stealthy and effective assassin. Please help me welcome Dan Norbert, corporate accountant. Let us see what our first ninja contestant can do. Oh, fantastic! Let's go to our panel of judges.
Nice moves. I give him a 10.
But Dan Norbert, look pretty dead.
9.5.
I don't know why I'm here. I don't know the first thing about martial arts. 6.5.
Sorry, folks. The other two ninja contestants were found decapitated backstage. Good night!
Come on, Travis. Let's have sex on my roommate's bed.
Oh, man, you're so dirty. I'm gonna get checked out.
Oh, it's almost as good as football. Oh, yeah. Oh, man, we're totally having sex. Yeah, this is the best.
Oh,
this is so good.
No, don't stop. I'm right there.
Anyone like to say a few words about Jeffrey? No one? Okay. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Seriously? No one has anything to say about me?
You're alive?
Oh, hell yes I am. I faked my death to see what people would say. Not much, I guess.
That is so messed up.
Oh, messed up is watching you text at my funeral, Linda.
Jeffrey, you are completely insane.
You didn't cry one tear. Not one. That is completely insane.
How could you do this?
You're a jerk.
A monster.
Asshole.
You back away. I am the victim here.
Dude, that's f***ed up.
Yeah, I had to take off work for this.
Get away. My chest hurts.
Ashes to ashes.
I'll never forget the first time I met Eagle Eye Smith. I was at the bar late one night when...
The name's Eagle Eye, and I'm a champ. I challenge you three to a game of pool.
I was the only one near the pool table. That's when I realized that Eagle Eye was blind as a bat.
I'ma break this puppy wide open.
I couldn't help feeling sorry for Eagle Eye, so I picked up two pool balls and held them close to his ear. Good shot, Eagle Eye.
Damn straight, fat ass. I'm stripes.
Eagle Eye hit a lot of balls that night, but not any on the pool table.
8 ball, call the pocket. I'm a champion.
And though he may not have won the game, he certainly won my heart. Home run, Eagle Eye.
I'm a champion.
Right, Eagle Eye.
I'm a champion.
Keep your ski tips up. We're almost at the top of the lift.
I'm gonna be a champion!
Okay, this is it.
These Alps are my bitch, mother...
Eagle Eye, are you okay?
Sometimes, Johnny, it's scary being blind.
Well, Eagle Eye, nobody else can see either. The sun went out years ago.
Really? So we all champions?
Yeah, we're all champions.
Champions.
I ain't gonna laugh at you.
Alright, don't get all gay on me, fatso. I'ma go show my girlfriend a good time.
Have fun, Eagle Eye.
How you like that, baby?
Oh, Eagle Eye, you're so big.
You know it, woman.
You're a champion, Eagle Eye.
That's right. I'm a champion.
The night my car careened off that Mississippi highway and flipped into a ditch is a night I'll never forget. To be fair, I don't remember much about the accident itself, as I was banged up pretty bad. There was much speculation as to what occurred on that unseasonably cold August night, but the most common thing I hear is, Morgan Freeman, you've been in more than 75 feature-length films. Why on God's green earth do you drive a 1997 Nissan Maxima? And for that question, like all questions, there's more than one answer. You see, a 97 Maxima represented a significant improvement over the previous year's model. And compared to my 89 Ford Probe, well, it wasn't even a fair contest. In 2002, there was a factory recall on the alternator. But I brought it right in, and they fixed it in a day or so. Even gave me a loaner, a brand new Altima. Nice car, but it's certainly no Maxima. Oh, and that right there? That's the flip that should have killed me. But thanks to Nissan's 5-star crash rating, along with dual airbags, crumple zones, seatbelt pretensioners, and side door beams, well, I'm alive today. I suppose the other noteworthy aspect of this story is, I've been fucking my own step-granddaughter.
Hey, do I know you?
Not yet.
You want to get out of here?
Absolutely. Hey! You stole my kidney, didn't you?
Oh, you got me. Oh, I guess I'm the asshole.
Well, okay, look at the mirror.
You?
Good luck selling that kidney.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I usually suck 3 or 4 male penises, and on several non-consecutive occasions I've run over a pet. Oh, and once I raped my own uncle. That is why I don't often drink beer.
Old McFano's had a farm, THANOS. And on that farm he had the only chickens left in the galaxy, THANOS. With a snap snap here and a snap snap there, here a snap, there a snap, everywhere a snap snap. Old McFano's had a farm, THANOS. Oh shit.
If his theory is correct, any one of those diseases could be used to camouflage him from the zombies.
But he doesn't know which diseases are in the vials.
No, not that one.
Oh, this is brutal. Oh, God, he's...
No. Yep, he just injected himself with AIDS.
He's worked.
Oh, but he definitely has AIDS now.
Oh, geez, he's celebrating. This is sad.
What's he doing now? Is he going back for more?
No, I can't watch this.
Oh God, we are making a snuff film.
Isn't AIDS a livable disease nowadays?
That's HIV, not AIDS.
Come on, no.
Oh, this is brutal.
What's he doing now?
Don't do it. This is absurd. Did he just drink his own piss?
He's all hopped up on AIDS.
Where did he get that sombrero?
It was first prize for putting a fork in World War Z.
Thank you, my libertarian friends, for making us your nominees for president and vice president of the United States of America!
1984 is the year of the Libertarian Party! We will be champions!
Yes, unfortunately, the rock band Queen won't let us play their hit, We Are the Champions, but enjoy this sound-alike, which we will play in the White House!
We are the victors of the globe, and we'll continue doing stuff.
4 years ago, I said we would be champions.
how wrong I was. Ronald Reagan soundly beat us.
In fact, we received less than 1% of 1% of the vote.
But it is 1988, and the country needs to come together like a family.
We are family. We are family.
Don't worry, Sister Sledge. This is not your copyright-protected musical hit, We Are Family. It's something better.
We are a close-knit group. Co-workers and acquaintances.
4 years ago, we asked America to join our family. America said no.
So we decided to make loving families of our own. Who else wants to get on board the love train?
And sadly, the OJs won't let us use their hit song, Love Train.
Even though it expresses every political ideal we stand for.
Next up, the White House.
Toot toot! All aboard!
Citizens of the Earth.
Come on.
Ride the French choo-choo. Ride the French choo-choo. Ride the French choo-choo.
Well, sadly, not a single voter chose to board the friendship choo-choo. Worse, despite using the sound-alike, the OJ still sued us.
During the 16-year legal battle, unsavory private matters were revealed, resulting in the spectacular in-court suicide of my beautiful wife, Danette.
My wife, Sarah, also committed suicide, but that was unrelated to the trial.
These tragedies taught us that life, like voting for a third party, are ultimately meaningless.
So, in the end, all we, the Libertarian Party, are is dust in the wind. I mean, all of us is airborne mini dirt.
Airborne mini dirt, y'all.
All of us is airborne mini dirt.
Betty Cooper was my high school sweetheart. She had blue eyes and hair like gold. But Veronica loved to let me have sex with her. And my love for Betty had turned cold. Then one day Veronica told me she was pregnant and the babe was mine. She said, let's run off away together and leave Riverdale and all our friends behind. I was scared, sir, I was just a boy now. I had been a junior in high school my whole life. I'm not lying or exaggerating when I say I've been in high school for my whole life. I told Veronica, hey, we ain't got no money. She smiled and said, that's all right. My daddy's safe is behind a painting. We'll take his money and run away tonight. Well, Mr. Lodge, he must have heard us. He stood in that doorway raising hell. I never saw Veronica raise that shotgun, but I watched that old man as he fell. She was laughing like a demon, and a shiver ran up my spine. But we made love beside her dead father, and together we stepped across that line. We went on killing, just killing and killing, making love in the blood that we spilled. I shot Jughead, she shot Hot Dog. Not even shooting Reggie left us fulfilled. We blew Moose's head off, but he was too dumb to notice. But I guess he could still feel jealousy. So when we set our sights on his girlfriend, Moose put an end to our killing spree. I don't know what really drove us to take all those lives so carelessly. I'd say keeping someone in high school forever and ever will cause some people to break down mentally. Now burning in the fires of hell, Lord, and forever will I scream and cry. But at least I'm no longer a junior. I finally graduated from Riverdale High.
Yo, Gabba Gabba, what the fuck? Hell no! Where's Luno? Fufa, Tootie, Roby, Plex!
I must have grabbed the wrong suitcase at the park.
You got the money.
Yeah, you got the stuff.
What are
those
things?
Where's my powder?
Pow! Pow!
What is death? Why do people die? It's one of life's unanswered questions, and no one knows why. You can die today, and you could die anywhere, like that guy whose ear is here, but his teeth are over there.
What's up, fellas? I've been looking for you guys everywhere. Oh, good. There's my suitcase. Now I can give this cornstarch back to its right.
Boom! DJ Lance? 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 DJ Lance?